हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ दिस इज द स्पर्मेटोजोआ, हेड ऑफ द स्पर्मेटोजोआ एक्रोसोमल कैप। इन द एक्रोसोमल कैप हायलुरिनरी एंजाइम इज प्रोड्यूस्ड। नाउ दिस इज दिस सेल्स आर नोन एज रेडियली अरेंज नोन एज द कोरोना रेडियाटा। कोरोना रेडियाटा, द सेल्स ऑफ द कोरोना रेडियाटा अटैच टू इथ ईच अदर बाई टाइट अटैचमेंट विद द हेल्प ऑफ द हायलुरिनरिक एसिड सिमिलर लाइक सबस्टेंस। Now, hyaluronidase enzyme dissolve the hyaluronic acid lies in the surface of the corona radiata cells. That lose the corona radiata, head of the spermatozoa, penetrate the ovum, zona pellucida and cytoplasmic membrane of the ovum. Now, after fertilization, meaning penetration or fertilization, the internal environment of the cytoplasm of the ovum is changed. As a result, this wave caused destruction of the receptor present on the side of the cell is damaged. So, after entry of one spermatozoa, no other spermatozoa will be able to penetrate because receptor which received the spermatozoa will be damaged after entry of the spermatozoa. Now after entry of the spermatozoa, it is known as the zygote. And now zygote by division 2 cell stage, 4 cell stage, 8 cell stage, 16 cell stage. And 16 cell stage is known as morula. Now morula arranged in two ring, that is outer ring known as the trophoblast cell and inner cell mass is known as the inner arrangement mass of the cell known as the inner cell mass. So morula divided into two ring separate trophoblast and inner cell mass. Now trophoblast again multiply to form the now in the trophoblast fluid appear. This fluid appear in this cavity, this is known as the blastocyst. This total mass is known as blastocyst content cavity containing fluid and surrounding trophoblast and the inner cell mass. Now this trophoblast cells produces finger-like process and with cytoplasm cell outline is lost. So all nucleus remain in one cytoplasm, that is known as syncytotrophoblast, and later on further arrangement of the cell occur, that is known as the cytotrophoblast. So syncytotrophoblast, cytotrophoblast and inner cell mass, and in inner layer of the cytotrophoblast mesoderm develop, that is known as extraembryonic mesoderm. Now these three layer, syncytotrophoblast, cytotrophoblast and in a primary mesoderm, primary by extraembryonic mesoderm, is as a whole, these three component is known as the chorion. And the cells in the cavity layer, this layer is changed into flat endothelium. This flat cells, blue color, is known as the endoderm. And this portion of the cell known as the amnion. This is about the general embryology at the beginning. Students, now in this inner cell mass, at all inner cell mass or at all primitive endoderm, a blue color, a cell glow change hoye, that converted into primitive endoderm. Acha. Ebar, this blue color endometrium bolchi, endoderm proliferate to form a sac. This is known as the yolk sac. Now in the amnion, this mass cell mass, inner cell mass now is known as the amnion. Fluid appear secreted by the cells, as a result of which cells passes to peripheral part and fluid limit inside. Now this becomes in such way. There is fluid. Now this after fluid, when the fluid remain inside and cells remain outside, now this cavity which is formed is known as the amniotic cavity. So amniotic cavity containing the fluid and yolk sac cavity, and the floor of the amniotic cavity, the cells in the floor of the amniotic cavity the cells in the floor of the amniotic cavity is known as the ectoderm, and roof of the yuxa cavity blue color, it is known as the endoderm. So ectoderm and endoderm. Now change in the ectoderm, it acts a ball in moto and the floor of the ball, that is the ectoderm, and it acts a ball, roof of the ball is known as the endoderm. So ectoderm and endoderm, two bilaminar germ discs, and in between ectoderm and endoderm there is development of the mesoderm. So ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm, three germ discs which is developed in future. Hello students, this one is the amniotic cavity, floor of the amniotic cavity is the ectoderm, this is the yuxa cavity, the roof of the yuxa cavity is the endoderm. Now this is the, from the ectoderm development of the notochord, this one is the notochord, and here there is mesoderm, comes from or developed from ectoderm. Now changes that occurs in the ectoderm, that is being seen in this picture, this one is the floor of the amniotic cavity or ectoderm. Now in the ectoderm, in this portion is the posterior part of the midline, thickening of the ectoderm known as the primitive streak, and nodular swelling in the primitive streak and the cranial end, that is known as the primitive node, and anterior to this in the midline there is groove, this groove is known as the neural groove, and margin is known as the neural crest, and the neural crest fuse with each other and form the neural tube, and that remains just deep to the ectoderm, that means lies in the in between ectoderm and the endoderm. Students, now we will discuss about the brain vesicle named ectoderm forming the neural tube. Upper portion of the neural tube enlarges known as the brain vesicle, and lower narrow portion known as the lower part of neural tube which developed from the ectoderm, and it forms the spinal cord. Now next picture, here the brain vesicle divided by two constriction, this constriction, two constriction, it is divided into three vesicle, that is forebrain vesicle, midbrain and hindbrain vesicle, and this is the foramen magnum in the occipital bone, and below that this neural tube forming the spinal cord. Now in the single tube, it is transverse section is done, here it is elaborated in this picture, here in the neural tube it, inner portion lining, that is tube, outer lining is the single layer of the ependymal cell, innermost lining. Now these cells has the power to proliferate, and that is known as the mantle layer. So inner portion, inner lining known as the ependymal layer, and second proliferation is known as the mantle layer. Mantle layer, cells of the mantle layer is responsible for development of the gray matter. And from the mantle layer, further proliferation, that is known as the marginal layer. That marginal layer forms the white matter. Now this mantle layer, that gray matter in the section of the spinal cord, the central canal of the spinal cord lined by the ependymal layer, and gray matter derived from the mantle layer, says butterfly like, that forms the anterior horn of the gray matter and posterior horn of the gray matter. Here there is cell body known as the anterior horn cell, here cell body, posterior horn cell body, anterior horn cell, posterior horn cell, and this one is the central canal of the spinal cord and lined by the ependymal lining, this one is the ependymal lining. And now marginal layer, which forms the white matter are the processes of the gray matter, that means cell body, axon, dendrite remains in this white matter. This develop from marginal layer and midline septum, that is posterior median septum, anterior median fissure. So in between anterior root and the anterior median fissure, this is known as the anterior white column. In between the anterior root and the posterior root, known as the lateral white column. And in between the posterior septum and the posterior root, that is known as the posterior white column. So gray matter, anterior horn, posterior horn, central canal, and হোয়াইট ম্যাটার, অ্যান্টিরিয়র হোয়াইট হোয়াইট কলাম, ল্যাটারাল হোয়াইট কলাম, পোস্টেরিয়র হোয়াইট কলাম, দিস ইজ অ্যাবাউট দ্য স্পাইনাল কর্ড। নাও দিস ফোর ভেসিকল, ফোর ব্রেন ভেসিকল, দিস ওয়ান ইজ দ্য ফোর ব্রেন ভেসিকল, মিড ব্রেন হাই মানে মিড ব্রেন ভেসিকল অ্যান্ড হাইন্ড ব্রেন ভেসিকল, দিস ফর্মস দ্য ফোর ব্রেন, দিস ফর্মস দ্য মিড ব্রেন, দিস ফর্মস দ্য হাইন্ড ব্রেন। নাও ইন দ্য নেক্সট ক্লাস উই উইল ডিসকাস অ্যাবাউট দ্য ডেভেলপমেন্ট অফ দ্য ব্রেন ফার্দার। Students, in this picture, forebrain vesicle, midbrain vesicle, hindbrain vesicle, foramen magnum, this lower part of neural tube forming the spinal cord. That's after section, this portion is ependymal layer, mantle layer and marginal layer. In such a three layers develop throughout the neural tube. Now, from the forebrain vesicle, develop the forebrain, midbrain vesicle, develop the midbrain, and hindbrain vesicle develop the hindbrain. Now, from the forebrain vesicle, just like a balloon, diverticulum develop, that is known as the telencephalic diverticulum, from right side and left side of the forebrain vesicle. And this communication, just like a diverticulum, this communication is known as the interventricular foramen. Now, this diverticulum, this from the wall of the diverticulum, this is lined by the ependymal lining, and outside that mantle layer, marginal layer, in such way cells proliferate, and the cavity that is known as telencephalic vesicle or telencephalic vesicle, and that forms the cerebral hemisphere, and the forebrain vesicle form the cavity of the lateral of the telencephalic vesicle forms the lateral ventricle, and the forebrain vesicle itself forming the third ventricle of the brain, and midbrain vesicle forming the midbrain, and cavity of the midbrain vesicle forming the cerebral aqueduct. Hello students, this is the forebrain vesicle. In this picture, forebrain vesicle, midbrain vesicle, hindbrain vesicle. Forebrain vesicle helps in formation of the forebrain. Now, from the forebrain vesicle, diverticulum starts from this region, that is known as the telencephalic vesicle. And this telencephalic vesicle wall lined by ependymion and proliferate to form the telencephalon, that is cerebral hemisphere, etc. And this communication to telencephalic vesicle from the forebrain vesicle This communication is known as the foramen of Monroe. Now, below that, midbrain vesicle. In the midbrain vesicle, due to development of the forebrain vesicle cerebrum, it is compressed and it cannot develop properly, as a result of which this midbrain vesicle converted into a tube, vesicle compressed to form a tube, and wall of the midbrain vesicle anteriorly forming the cross cerebri substantia nigra, through which fibers from the cerebral hemisphere passes along this region, and posteriorly this elevation, that is known as the superior and inferior colliculus, as a whole is known as tectum or corpora quadrigemina. And this midbrain vesicle tube itself, it is known as the cerebral aqueduct, which connects the forebrain vesicle with the hindbrain vesicle. Now, in this hindbrain vesicle, this anterior wall forming the pons and the medulla, and posterior wall forming the cerebellum. Now, hindbrain vesicle derived pons, medulla anteriorly, cerebellum posteriorly. So, hindbrain consists of pons, medulla and cerebellum, and the cavity, hindbrain vesicle itself forming the fourth ventricle. So, this forebrain vesicle forms the third ventricle. So, third ventricle communicate with the forebrain vesicle via cerebral aqueduct, which is the cavity of the midbrain vesicle, compressed cavity. And this is the foramen of Monroe. Now, in this portion, anterior part of the midbrain, pons and medulla as a whole is known as the brainstem, and hindbrain, pons, medulla and cerebellum, because it develops from the hindbrain vesicle. This is the foramen magnum in the occipital bone, and through which passes the neural tube, which forms the spinal cord. This is about the basic idea. Now, midbrain, after section of the midbrain, this one is the posterior, this one is the anterior, this is the cerebral aqueduct, and this cerebral aqueduct. Now, posteriorly, superior colliculus, two right and left, inferior colliculus, two right and left. So, four colliculus, and in the midline, this cerebral aqueduct, and in front of the cerebral aqueduct, this cross cerebri and pigmented cell known as the substantia nigra, and this is known as the tegmentum. In this region, red nucleus, third cranium nucleus, fourth cranium nucleus are present in this region. This is about the midbrain. So, midbrain consists of posterior part, that is tectum, and anterior part, that is known as cerebral peduncle, which consists of cross cerebri, substantia nigra, and tegmentum as a whole is known as the cerebral peduncle.
Students, this one is the lateral ventricle lined by the ependymal cell layer. Now, by proliferation, there is mantle layer, that is the granular mantle layer for forming the gray matter, and by outside there is marginal layer, white matter. But due to huge proliferation of the gray matter, that is the mantle layer, it migrates towards the surface, and white matter passes inwards and remains inside in this region, and gray matter, that is mantle layer, passes in the surface, periphery. So, in the cerebrum, this one is the cerebrum, and this elevation is known as the sulcus, and this groove is known as the gyrus, and this is the cerebral cortex, and here is the white matter. Now, in the cerebral cortex, there are six layers. Anyway, there is sulci, a gyrus, as this elevation, and this in between the two gyrus, the depression is known as sulcus. Now, covering of the brain is known as the meninges. Meninges has two layers. This one is the dura mater, arachnoid mater, pia mater. Deep to the arachnoid mater, subarachnoid space, here lies the CSF and blood vessels. Now, in the arachnoid mater, in between the endothelial layer and meningeal layer, in between endothelial layer and meningeal layer, these in between two layer, there is triangular gap in the midline of the sciascal, and here there is venous sinus known as superior sagittal sinus. Now, arachnoid matter forms arachnoid granulation, which is the communication between the subarachnoid space and the venous sinus. That CSA passes from this space through the arachnoid granulation into the venous sinus. Now, this is the dura mater, arachnoid mater and pia mater, subarachnoid space. Now, this one is the pia mater, and this folding of pia mater is known as telachoroid. Now in between the arachnoid and subarachnoid space there is blood vessels, and here is also blood vessels forming the capillary plexus known as choroid plexus. Choroid plexus. Now from the choroid plexus capillary, blood passes from the capillary to the lateral ventricle, that is known as CSF, plasma CSF. So this is known as the blood CSF barrier. In this blood CSF barrier, number one, this capillary endothelium, basement membrane, then pyameter. This one is black color is the pyameter, then ependymema. So capillary endothelium, basement membrane, pyameter and ependymal cell layer, these four structure forming the blood CSF barrier, that is the plasma fluid plus watery part of the plasma passes through the blood CSF barrier into the lateral ventricle. From the lateral ventricle as well as from third ventricle, CSF is formed, and from CSF from lateral ventricle process through foramen of Monroe, and from foramen of Monroe through foramen of Monroe passes third ventricle, then through aqueduct of Sylvius fourth ventricle, from fourth ventricle it passes out of the ventricle through foramen Magendie midline and laterally to Lusca foramen. Through this foramen passes to the subarachnoid space. Through the subarachnoid space it passes upwards, and then it passes through the arachnoid granulation into venous sinus. Now this vein ultimately pours into the right atrium of the heart via internal jugular vein. Students, this is the lateral ventricle, dura mater, dural venous sinus, arachnoid granulation, subarachnoid space, CSF and blood vessels. CSF passes through arachnoid granulation into superior sagittal sinus. Now choroid plexus is blood vessels capillary plexus, is from the in the subarachnoid space. This choroid plexus produces CSF, passes through the blood CSF barrier into the lateral ventricle. From here it passes through the interventricular foramen of Monroe to the third, then it via aqueduct to fourth ventricle, then via Magendie and Lusca passes to subarachnoid space. From here it passes through the subarachnoid space into the venous sinus via arachnoid granulation. Now this CSF via venous blood superior sagittal sinus passes via transverse sinus internal jugular vein, then at the root of the neck it unite with the subclavian vein to form the brachiocephalic vein, which forms unite to opposite side to form SVC, that opens into the right atrium. This is about the CSF formation and drainage. You know CSF pressure 100 to 200 millimeter of H2O, protein 20 to 40 millimeter of per 100 ml. Now lumbar puncture is done at the level of L3 and L4 spine, 1 drop per second via lumbar puncture needle, and it maintains the intracranial pressure, protects the brain as the water jacket and exchange nutrient. A rate of formation of CSF is the 20 ml per minute. Okay, this is about the CSF, and this is the flow chart where it passes to the right atrium of the heart via right atrium of the heart. Students, this is the third ventricle coming from developed from four vent vesicle, lateral ventricle, foramen of Monroe. Now here lies the choroid plexus. Now we are talking about the cortex, gray matter remained outside. At this actually migration from the mantle layer, all the gray matter, mantle cells of the mantle layer migrate to the surface, forming the cortex, cerebral cortex or gray matter. Now during development, some group of the cell fails to migrate from the mantle layer. They remain in this mantle layer region, and this subcortical white matter region, this failure forming the basal ganglia. So the group of the cell which fails to migrate from mantle layer to the surface to form the gray matter and the cortex, These group of the cell are known as the basal ganglia, which consist of lens-shaped form nucleus known as the lentiform nucleus. This one is the lentiform nucleus. Now, another tail-like, that is known as the caudate nucleus, and this is the amygdaloid nucleus, and this is known as the basal ganglia in the subcortical region. This group of the cell fails to migrate from the mantle layer to the surface, outer cortex. Now, this basal ganglia is the first to activate in the fetal life for movement of the fetus. Now, there are fiber. These are the cell body, then these are the axons, fibers. From the cortex, fibers, these are the axons, passes downwards towards the spinal cord. Now, it's some fiber connected with each other. This one is from the gyrus to gyrus of the same cerebral hemisphere. The fiber connects to gyrus to gyrus, that is known as the association fiber. Bandhu bandhav local. Now, some fibers from the students. Now, we will discuss about the diencephalon developed from the forebrain vesicle. This forebrain vesicle produce lateral diverticulum, that is telencephalic vesicle, from where it is developed. The lateral ventricle and from the mantle layer and marginal layer proliferate to form the cerebral hemisphere, subcortical basal ganglia and lateral ventricle. This is the telencephalon. Now forebrain vesicle forming the diencephalon. Now this diencephalon or forebrain vesicle wall lined by the ependymal lining. Outside that, and external to that, there is mantle layer. Outside that, marginal layer. Now, it is the midline sagittal section. So, medial, just like say, midline section of the gourd or cabbage, in medial surface. That is the medial surface of the cerebrum and developing embryo. So, in inner wall, cavity of the forebrain vesicle, in the lateral wall of the forebrain vesicle, in the mantle layer, the egg-like mass, lateral wall, it forms the thalamus. This one is the thalamus, and from the floor of the diencephalic vesicle or forebrain vesicle, below the thalamus, that is known as the structure on forming the hypothalamus. This is formed by the optic chiasma in this position, and this is the pituitary or hypophysis, and then large mammillary body and posterior perforated substance and tegmentum. This is about the structure forming the hypothalamus, which lies, it lies below the hypothalamus. Now, above the hypothalamus, there is posterior projection that is known as the pineal body or epithalamus. So, diencephalon consists of thalamus, hypothalamus and epithalamus, that is pineal body. And lateral side of the hypothalamus, two rounded body develop, which on the lies on the lateral side surface of the diencephalon, known as lateral and medial geniculate body, which are known as metathalamus. So, diencephalon consists of thalamus, hypothalamus, epithalamus and metathalamus outside the outer surface of the diencephalon or forebrain vesicle. This is about the diencephalon. Now, midbrain vesicle forming the midbrain. So, cavity forming the aqueduct. Behind the aqueduct, there is four elevation. In this picture, these four elevation, this is known as the superior colliculus and inferior colliculus, 2 and 2, 4. That's why these are known as a whole known as the corpora, quadrigeminal or tectum. Corpora means body, quadri means char, corpora, quadrigemina or tectum. And cerebral aqueduct and anterior to cerebral aqueduct, these three structure, that is cross cerebri, substantia nigra and tegmentum, these three structure forming the cerebral peduncle. So midbrain consists of behind the cerebral aqueduct, this portion is known as tectum or corpora quadrigemina or colliculus, superior and inferior colliculus, and in front of the aqueduct, that is cerebral peduncle, this consists of cross cerebri, which contains descending fiber, pyramidal tract, then pigmented cell, substantia nigra, and then tegmentum, which contains ascending fiber. And this is about the midbrain.
This is about the midbrain. Now this is the pons and this is the medulla from the hindbrain vesicle, anterior wall and posterior wall of the hindbrain vesicle forming the cerebellum and cavity of the hindbrain vesicle forming the fourth ventricle. This is about the diencephalon, midbrain, pons, medulla and cerebellum. Students, this is the pyramidal tract, cerebral cortex homunculus. From fifth layer of cerebral cortex, pyramidal cell starts in converging manner. This is known as the corona radiata. This corona radiata forms the internal capsule that is converged to form a aggregated form, that is internal capsule, in between the lentiform nucleus on the laterally, caudate nucleus and thalamus medially. In the, through the gap, the fibers of the internal capsule, that is pyramidal tract, passes downwards as the cross cerebri in the midbrain, then passes to the through the pons and then passes to the medulla. In the medulla, left-sided fiber crosses to the opposite right-sided fiber. After crossing the cross pyramidal tract, continues as the lateral corticospinal tract and ends in the anterior horn cell of the spinal cord in corresponding segmental level. This is the upper motor neuron, and from the anterior horn cell the fiber passes as the anterior root trunk and a ventral ramus or dorsal ramus to supply the target organ. This is the lower motor neuron. So lower motor neuron is the final common pathway in descending tract, pyramidal tract.